Hello, it's the Wikstrand, and this is introduction video number 4. So let's talk about actresses this time. This is basically the same thing. I have here a list of... here I have a bunch of actresses from the last 9 decades, and we're gonna talk about them. So, let's get cracking. Gwyneth Paltrow. Gwyneth Paltrow is one of the actresses I dislike most, probably. She's okay. It's just her... well, all of the Gwyneth Paltrow-ness she does. Just... no. Sandra Bullock. It's odd thing about Sandra Bullock. She's the older she gets, the better she becomes an actress. I had real problem with her in the 90s when she was sort of your go-to girl for all the romantic comedies, and she has really improved in recent years, especially Gravity. Anne Hathaway. For some reason, Anne Hathaway isn't really liked. For some reason, I don't know. I personally like her a lot. I think she has done quite a decent amount of movies. I didn't like Les Miserables that much, but I think that Brokeback Mountain and The Dark Knight Rises was quite good. Oh, and speaking of the Dark Knight Rises, Marion Cotillard is a fantastic actress. The only problem with her is that she's a bit too typecast as the sort of dark and villainous woman who has something dark over her. It's a shame. I think she could do also other stuff, but she's really good. Rosario Dawson. I think she's kind of awesome. She has a stronger personality and more charisma than she have acting ability, but you can always rely on her to deliver a pretty good performance, or at least a memorable one. Ellen Page. I like Ellen Page. I think she's good. Zooey Deschanel. Zooey Deschanel is pretty good. She can be a bit too whimsical sometimes, but she's usually pretty good, except for The Happening. Nobody came out of The Happening looking happy. That's one thing for sure. Sigourney Weaver. She's one of my favorite actresses of all time. Of course, her work in Alien is absolutely stellar, but she's also really funny. Her comedies are really, really solid, especially Heartbreakers and Galaxy Quest. They are both fantastic. Liv Tyler. Steven Tyler's daughter has not been seen in a lot of movies as of lately. I think she's not that good an actress, but she did a pretty good Arwen. I'll give her that. Rachel McAdams. I like Rachel McAdams. She's really good at playing these, you know, very diverse characters, and I think she's good. Jennifer Aniston. For me, she's okay, but she's not one of my favorite actresses, but she's serviceable. Lois Maxwell. Lois Maxwell is probably most famous for Moneypenny, but she's done some other stuff too that is pretty good. She's good, I like her. Charlize Theron, my favorite actress of all time. I think she's fantastic in virtually everything she does. I think she deserved to have more Oscar statuettes at her house than what she has. I think she's maybe one of the best actresses of all time, my favorite, and she's awesome. Cate Blanchett. She's also one of these absolutely stellar actresses, and whatever she's playing, she always just sort of delivers on all cylinders. So, tops for her, she's good. Michelle Pfeiffer, oh, the queen of the 80s. Michelle Pfeiffer has a fantastic charisma. She's really funny, and she always delivers, good roles, and she is the best Catwoman of all time. Audrey Hepburn. Audrey Hepburn is, of course, an absolute legend, and she is a fantastic icon. I don't know how fantastic she is as an actress. I think she's at least, serviceable, but her iconic status is probably higher than her ability to act, but icons are icons. Reese Witherspoon. Nope, I don't like Reese Witherspoon. This might be a fact that I don't like her personally, more maybe than her acting ability, but it's difficult sometimes to separate the two. Tilda Swinton. Nobody plays an ice queen like Tilda Swinton. I think she's pretty fantastic. This is also a slight case of the typecasting. I read an article once, if she plays one more ice queen, then it is some kind of a bullying from Hollywood. I must say I agree with her a little bit. Halle Berry. Halle Berry is probably the worst actress of all time that has been given an Academy Award. If you don't believe me, see Catwoman. She really needs a very good director who can make her at least serviceable. Anna Kendrick, the most charming woman in the world, probably, and she's just fun to watch. She's funny, she's always. She has a nice feeling about Anna Kendrick. More of her, please. Gal Gadot. The woman who was born to play Wonder Woman is, of course, good as Wonder Woman, but I haven't seen her in anything else that I really, liked. She was okay in the Fast and Furious movies, but apart from that, no. Diane Lane. Diane Lane is a very good actress, and I don't have anything, bad to say about her. I never look forward to a Diane Lane movie, but she's always good. Isabella Skorupko, the Polish-Swedish actress, has been responsible for a bunch of pretty good movies, but never really solid performances, in my opinion. But she's okay. Renée Russo. Renée Russo is a pretty good actress. Renée Russo is a pretty good actress, and she always delivers solid performances. I think she was one of the best things in Nightcrawler, and she really bred new life in the Lethal Weapon series. Gabrielle Union. Yeah, she's pretty okay. Margot Robbie. Margot Robbie is probably the best actress that has come out in the last couple of years. She's absolutely fantastic in The Wolf of Wall Street. I liked her a lot I liked her a lot in The Suicide Squad. She was one of the few actually good things about that movie. And I hope to see a lot more of her in upcoming years. Kim Basinger, oh, the other queen of the 80s. I think she's pretty okay. I like Pfeiffer more than Basinger, but She's good. Gwendolyn Christie. Gwendolyn Christie is probably most famous for Brienne in Game of Thrones and Captain Phasma in Star Wars Episode 7. But well, yeah, I like her. She's pretty awesome. Monica Bellucci. Monica Bellucci is probably one of the best charismas in the world. She just oozes of star power. I think she's pretty awesome. Jennifer Connelly. Jennifer Connelly has for a good part of 25 years delivered solid performances whenever she turns up. She's fantastic. Olivia de Havilland. Olivia de Havilland is probably most famous for all her movies with Errol Flynn, where she was playing the love interest of Errol Flynn. I think he's pretty good. Oh, more Game of Thrones. Emilia Clarke. I don't know. I have never seen her put on a good performance outside of Game of Thrones. I don't know if it is because she is protected by good writing and good directors. I think she has talent. Only she needs the right people and the right script to work. Julia Roberts. I don't like Julia Roberts. In fact, I hate Julia Roberts. She rarely puts on anything that I like. It's basically that she always plays the same character, and I hate that character. Amy Adams. Amy Adams is really good. She's sort of the Matt Damon with tits. Basically, she always is good at playing, you know, the normal woman, and that's basically what she does. She's good at it, but there is never any, you know, anything special about her performances, in my opinion. But she's never bad. Rose McGowan. Rose McGowan is a pretty shitty actress, but she always ends up in kind of interesting roles and entertaining movies. Melissa McCarthy, she's probably the best talker in Hollywood. Her verbal abuses and rants is hysterically funny. She doesn't always pick good movies to do these rants in, but when it's good, it's really good. Penelope Cruz, she's fantastically talented and she just oozes with charisma. I like her. She's very good. Salma Hayek, she's really funny, and I think she's good, but she always is best when she gets to play sort of slightly over the top characters and when she gets to be funny. Rebecca Ferguson. When Rebecca Ferguson started talking Swedish in the fifth Mission Impossible movie, I was sort of like, this sounds a little strange. But she pulled it off. She's really fantastic in that movie, and I haven't seen that many more movies with her, but based on that movie and some one or two movies I've seen more, indicates that she's gonna be a pretty big star and that we will see a lot more of her. Terry Hatcher. Nope. Lena Olin. Lena Olin doesn't do any more movies in Hollywood, but there was a time during the 80s and the 90s when she was pretty fantastic, and she always had this presence about her that made all her performances very memorable. Personal favorite, The Ninth Gate. Meryl Streep. Being nominated for, 17 Academy Awards or something like that, That's mental. She of course is really talented, but she's not really my cup of tea when it comes to actresses. She's of course extremely talented and she never, makes bad roles, but I don't know, it's maybe a personal thing. I don't hate her, I don't even dislike her, I just don't think she is that good as everybody says she is. Michelle Rodriguez, oh yes. All you vatos, you better watch out because this badass bitch is gonna come to whoop your fucking ass. Michelle Rodriguez is pretty much one of the most awesome actresses of all time. When she really goes to town with, guys or girls, you know that she's gonna beat the living shit out of them. She's not a very good actress, but she really has the. You really get the feeling that you're getting your ass whooped when you see her. Alicia Vikander. I loved her in Ex Machina. I've seen a lot of other movies with her, and I think she's really good. Katie Holmes. Katie Holmes is pretty shitty. She's pretty terrible. She, no. Mila Jovovich. Jovovich isn't, this might not be a good actress, but she's really memorable. You're not forgetting anything soon when you're seeing her strange performances. Audrey Tautou. There's one word that always comes to mind when I think of Audrey Tautou, and that is charm. She has the ability to charm the living hell out of you, whatever the, subject may be. She's just so goddamn likable and charming. Sarah Jessica Parker. I don't like her. I haven't seen that many movies with her, but I've never seen any role that she's played that I've sort of liked her for that character, and that's it. Renée Zellweger. I hate Renée Zellweger. She's the worst thing that ever happened to cinemas. Oof. Scarlett Johansson. Scarlett Johansson is very good, and please give us a Black Widow movie. Jodie Foster. Jodie Foster is really good. This is a funny thing. One of the few movies that she has done that I don't love that much is actually Silence of the Lambs. Almost all other movies I've seen her in, I think she's pretty awesome. But except Silence of the Lambs, I think she's serviceable in that one. Maybe it was her accent that I didn't like. Nicole Kidman. There was a time I actually loathed Nicole Kidman. I didn't like anything that she did, mostly because I thought she was dead and her body just kept living and acting. She was sort of she was like a ghost that sort of just walking around and having about as much charisma as a brick. She has improved in recent years, so I cannot rag too much about her. But there was a time. Oh, there was a time. Mia Farrow. I like Mia Farrow, especially in her Woody Allen movies. She always delivers. Lucy Liu. Lucy Liu is pretty fucking awesome. I like her especially in the more when she either is funny or when she. I like her when she's either funny or an absolute badass. Anne Margaret, an absolute legend. She has made some of the best performances I've seen in the golden days of Hollywood. Helena Bonham Carter. I love Helena Bonham Carter. She always has this craziness over her. The fact that it took her so long to be married to Tim Burton is kind of mind-blowing. You would assume, hasn't she always been married to Tim Burton? She's really good. She always brings out, you know, the craziest performances. Jada Pinkett Smith. I think she's okay, but not my cup of tea. Jessica Chastain. Jessica Chastain hasn't done a lot of movies since Zero Dark Thirty for some reason. At least not I've seen. I think she was really good in that movie. I think also she was excellent in the movie Lawless, but after that, I don't think I've seen her in anything else. But I like her. She's good. Oh, Interstellar, of course. Sorry, forgot it. Lupita Nyong'o. She's, of course, most famous for 12 Years a Slave. I liked her also in I also liked her in Nonstop. I think she's really talented, and I think she's really fantastic. Alicia Silverstone. No, she's not very good. And Batman and Robin has also tarnished her entire career. I cannot see her without her hearing those awful lines. Oof. Glenn Close. Glenn Close is pretty fun. Fatal Attractions is, of course, her best role ever. But she's also done some other interesting things. Faye Dunaway. I never really liked Faye Dunaway. She's okay, but sort of her. I think she's a little overrated. Of course, Getaway was a pretty awesome movie, but I don't know. I think she's overrated. Denise Richards. Denise Richards is a pretty face and with not that much talent. I don't have anything more to say. She tried to play a nuclear scientist named Christmas Jones. I don't know how you're gonna do anything after that and be taken seriously. Ava Gardner, she's stellar. She's one of the best old-timey actresses that Hollywood can say has acted. I think she's kind of awesome. Betty Garble. I think Betty Garble was okay. She might be remembered more fondly than she deserves. I think she was okay, but not really that fantastic. Rachel Weisz, or should it be more Weiss, is of course one of Britain's best actresses. She has the ability to elevate the movie. If the movie is okay, she can make it awesome. If it is awesome, she can make it a fantastic movie. That's what she does. Katherine Heigl, please make it stop. I hate her. Catherine Zeta-Jones. Catherine Zeta-Jones is pretty good. She does, however, requires a really good director to bring out the best in her. But if done correctly, she can be good. Gina Carano. Gina Carano is basically a tank wrapped in human skin. She's an MMA fighter who really, when she's battling people, you really feel that she is taking you down to the beat downtown, basically. She may not be a good actress, but she can really whoop ass. Brigitte Nielsen. Brigitte Nielsen became an actress because she was together with Sylvester Stallone, and she had that physique. I guess it didn't require anything else back in the 80s. She's hideous as an actress, but her car crashes of performances are fun to watch. I'm giving her that one. Amanda Peet. Amanda Peet hasn't done a lot of movies lately, but she is one of the funniest women of all time, and I think she, when casted correctly, can be one of the best things about a movie. Kristen Stewart. Kristen Stewart. She was really good in Panic Room. And then she became basically the chick who has the same voice and the same face when we're winning the lottery and burying a loved one. This is her, I mean, she's just nothing. Si Shang. Si Shang is most famous for most Western audience as she's most famous, of course, for Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon and Rush Hour 2. But I've seen her in some other movies, martial arts movies, and she's pretty fantastic. She actually can't do any martial arts. She's actually a ballet dancer. Her background is actually a ballet dancer, and which makes it all the more impressive. Good. Beyonce Knowles. Beyonce Knowles is not a very good actress, but she really can sing. I would not say that she's awful. She's just not that good of an actress. Naomi Harris. Naomi Harris is really good, and she has put on some really seriously good movies. My personal favorite, 28 Days Later. Pamela Anderson. If Pamela Anderson didn't have two gigantic boobs, she probably wouldn't have gotten anywhere in Hollywood, but now Hollywood works as Hollywood works, so she has gotten she got a pretty good TV career and made some seriously awful movies. She's a pretty atrocious actress. Apart maybe from Borat. I really bought into the fact that she was being chased by Borat for real. She was actually good in that role. I having problem actually accepting that, but I thought she was good in Borat. Megan Fox. Basically, the Pamela Anderson thing, but replace big tits with a pretty face. I think she's pretty terrible, of course. She couldn't act her way out of a fish barrel. Ashley Judd. She is, without a doubt, Hollywood's most underused actress. She always brings out the best in her characters, and she always elevates movies, but it's very rare that she performs in anything else than a, you know, small side character that maybe with 5 or 10 minutes screen time. It's a shame. Jennifer Lopez. Jennifer Lopez, she's basically two steps down from the singers trying to become movie stars. She's basically two steps down from Beyoncé in this case. She's pretty atrocious. I don't like her music either. Noomi Rapace. Noomi Rapace is pretty good. Of the Swedish women going to Hollywood as lately, I wouldn't rank her as high as, let's say, Alicia Vikander or Rebecca Ferguson, but she's good. Zoe Saldana. Zoe Saldana is pretty good. I like her. Vivica A. Fox. Vivica A. Fox is not really that good of an actress, but she's always serviceable at least. Anna Nicole Smith. This is basically the Pamela Anderson argument, but up to 11. She has no talent. She had absolutely no talent whatsoever. I've never seen any actress of all. She is the actress that I've never seen an actress with this little talent. Deepika Padukone. I probably mispronounced that severely. I'm so sorry. She is probably the biggest movie star in India. And Happy New Year. What a movie that was. And Om Shanti Om. What a movie that was. Uma Thurman. Uma Thurman is really good. And there's a reason that she got to play the bride in Kill Bill. She really is very good. Neve Campbell. Neve Campbell is funny, and I think she has gone better with age, and I think she's nice, and I think she's good. Jennifer Tilly. If you can stand her very annoying voice, she does have some good performances to make, but you really have to get around this strange voice of hers. Greta Garbo. Garbo is, of course, an absolute legend. I like her in most movies I've seen with her. Michelle Yeoh. Michelle Yeoh is, of course, one of the coolest actresses of all time. She's basically like a Jackie Chan type of actress, you know, performing her own stunts and doing ludicrously stuff. The sequence in Super Cop when she jumps with a motorcycle on onto an unspeeding train, for real, is absolutely bizarre. Lauren Bacall. Lauren Bacall is one of these absolutely legends of the industry that really has this, you know, diva star power. I like her. Jennifer Hudson. A bit of a mixed bag with Jennifer Hudson. Some movies she makes are pretty good and some is pretty terrible. Overall, it's a mixed bag, but I like most of her work. Jennifer Lawrence. She's desperately now trying to get away from Katniss, I suppose. And she has done it pretty well. I think she's really good. Personal favorite, American Hustle. Natalie Portman. Natalie Portman is fantastic. She has done a lot of very good movies, and she always shines as one of the greatest stars. Nathalie Emmanuel. Nathalie Emmanuel is a British actress who's probably most famous for Miss Sandy in the Game of Thrones. I think she's really good. She's probably one of the best actresses from Game of Thrones, which I've seen in other movies where she's good. I think she's probably one of the best actresses in the Fast and Furious movies. Sophia Loren. Sophia Loren is this amazing diva. She's probably the biggest diva of all time, for better or for worse. It is fantastic to see her. You cannot argue, you cannot take that away from her. Jessica Alba. Jessica Alba is not very good. No. Paula Patton. Paula Patton, yeah, she's good. Rihanna, please get back to more singing and less acting, please. Battleship, oh my god. Linda Hamilton, she will forever be Sarah Connor. She hasn't done anything else really that is worth mentioning, but we will always have Linda Hamilton. Julie Christie is fantastic. She's one of my favorite actresses of her generation. Her roles in Doctor Zhivago and Don't Look Now is pretty fucking amazing. Jessica Biel. No, she's not very good. She's actually quite kind of terrible. Grace Kelly, always one, also one of these fantastic legends. Tia Carrera. Tia Carrera is not very good. She's serviceable at best. Sofia Boutella. Sofia Boutella is probably most famous for her role as the legless assassin in the Kingsman, and also maybe for the remake of The Mummy. I think she's kind of awesome. We'll see more of her hopefully, and I would also like to have her in, you know, fewer bad guy roles, and maybe, you know, having her as sort of an anti-hero thing going on. I think we're gonna see more of her in the future. Helen Mirren. There is something extremely dignity. She has so much dignity about her. She's funny and she's talented. She's really good. Raquel Welch. Raquel Welch, well, she was basically the Pamela Anderson of the 1960s, but I think she was more attractive actually. But no, not a great talent, but she has an iconic look. Kate Beckinsale. Kate Beckinsale is good. She was born to play Selena in the Underworld movies, and but my personal favorite of her is actually the old British movie Shooting Fish. That's my favorite movie with her. Diane Kruger. Is it Kruger or Krieger? I like her. She has some gravitas about her. I like her. Barbara Stanwyck. The fact that Barbara Stanwyck never got an Oscar is mental. She was one of the best in the world of playing these the dames in the 1940s. You know, these sort of unreliable, tough women's, and she was really good at it. And the fact that she never got an Oscar is a bit atrocious. Double Indemnity is her finest work by far. Jennifer Garner. Jennifer Garner is pretty good. Melanie Griffith, also one of these iconic 80s performers. Not my cup of tea, really. Kelly Hu. Kelly Hu is good. Kelly Hu is good. Emma Stone. Emma Stone is one of these new and upcoming and charming actresses, and she has yet to do a bad movie or a bad performances. We're still waiting. It will happen eventually, but she's really good at picking both roles and movies. Sanaa Lathan. Sanaa Lathan is not exactly, you know, one of the top actresses in Hollywood, and she will probably never be. She's okay. Maybe Alien vs. Predator will always be, you know, tarnishing her legacy. Emily Blunt. Emily Blunt is fantastic. She, if you need a really good, you know, action Storm. She's your go-to girl. Judy Garland. I haven't seen that many movies with Judy Garland, but it's difficult not to like her in The Wizard of Oz. Elizabeth Taylor, Cleopatra. She may be a one-trick pony when it comes to, being the entire diva thing, but she really has had an impressive look and feel about her. Britt Ekland. Britt Ekland is a pretty shitty actress. Anne Bancroft. Well, she will always be the graduate, but she has done some pretty awesome movies apart from that, and yeah, she's good. Bette Davis. Bette Davis is cowboy, is awesome. Asin. Asin is, of course, one of the fantastic actresses of Bollywood, with equal parts acting chops and equal part dancing and singing ability. She's amazing. Grace Jones. She's also amazing, but she's kind of a more of a nature force. She always plays, these larger-than-life characters that is completely bizarre. And I like that in some case. Go all or go home. Mila Kunis. Why does Mila Kunis get job all the time? She's not very funny. She doesn't have any personality. She doesn't have a lot of charisma, and I don't really like her. Katrina Kaif is pretty good. Also one of these Bollywood babes with a lot of acting ability, and I like her. She's good. Tara Reid, she's awful. She's one of the worst actresses of all time. Pam Grier. Pam Grier may not have the best acting ability of all time, but she has charisma and she has a presence about her. You know that she's a bad mama who's gonna whoop your ass, boy. She's amazing. I like her. Keira Knightley. Keira Knightley is pretty okay. I don't have anything to say. She's okay. Diane Keaton is really funny, and she's a really good actress. I like her. Julianne Moore. Julianne Moore is a really good actress, but Hollywood, do you really need to keep, casting her as midlife crisis woman? She can do other stuff, Eva Green. She's the best. She's France's best actress. She's fantastic. She has this presence about her. She always delivers in all movies she does. She is one of these actresses that elevates movies. Kerry Washington. Kerry Washington is she's okay. She's fine. Ke Xu is a very good Chinese actress who is pretty fantastic. So that was it. That was quite a lot of movies and quite a lot of minutes and quite a lot of actresses. So that was number four. One more to go. The Wikstrand is signing out.